Maritime and Coast Guard Agency employs over 1,200 people and are supported by 3,500 volunteer Coast Guard rescue officers. They can get paged at any time during the day or night. Do you want to go to the seaside? I'm not trying to say that everybody wants to go. I fell in love at the seaside. She handled her charm with time and sleight of hand.
Search area is Amble to the port gate, Hudson, with the tide in a northerly direction. But I'm just trying to love
you any kind of way. What my role is basically to run the operational capability of the team, make sure that all the care maintenance is done, take charge and plan major incidents, get involved with the training.
Some of the stuff's alright, yeah, when we go out and do the search exercises out in the elements and things like that, whether it's rain, sun, snow, we're always prepared to go out and get wet, get warm, whatever, as long as someone's life on the risk on the end, you know, and we're fully trained to go and do something like that.
It's quite apprehensive and a general rush. It's really the unknown. It's one minute you can be sitting at home and the next minute this pager goes off loudly and you just don't know what to expect until you get to the station.
I joined the Coast Guard. I've always been a diver and into fishing. It's just sort of a bit of weird putting something back into Amble, you know. So that's why I joined. Most dangerous situations probably January the 2nd, 2002. We got paged of an angler in the water, freezing cold. Big sea on, and the lifeboat capsized. Inshore lifeboat capsized, and the Amble team helped the lifeboat crew out. And there was a few involved in that, and looking back at the video of it, it was pretty scary. Like, so I'd say that's the most dangerous one.
Custom Mobile, this is Amble 6, Amble 6, radio check, channel 99, over. I'm actually part of the search team. I'm just keeping an eye at the back, at the actual line straight, and that they're covering the area they're asked to look for the casualty. And I'm just keeping back as a bit of a team leader, just to ensure that the line is correct and that we're not missing, but the probability of missing anyone is reduced.
See, the track spacing here is about 10 metres. The guy at the top's got the first aid kit, the guy at this end's got this stretcher.
Sorry?
Messages?
You'll be at 02, Mr. Mobile, yes, that's all copy.
It's good, I'm waiting.
Right, yeah, well, as you can see, we've located our first casualty in the southern sector. The casualty's walking wounded. She's got a lower arm injury, fractured her lower arm.
We've just done that for a treaty.
We normally get called out for people in distress in boats, searching for people like doing this exercise in here. Sometimes unexploded ordnance, people believe some bombs can be still left on the beach. Generally, sometimes suicides, attempted suicides, missing children, animals in the sea, boats missing, a number of different things.
And she's slightly hypothermic, so what we intend to do is, because we're in a remote location, we're going to medevac her out on an inshore lifeboat, which we're waiting on now, and that's going to take her to the all-weather lifeboat, where she'll be treated for her injuries and then taken ashore and taken to hospital.
The Coast Guard work with the lifeboat and RAF crews when finding casualties in awkward places where the vehicles can't get to.
The reason why I became a Coast Guard was to give someone back to the community. Obviously I come from a fishing background. I'm not a fisherman myself, but I thought that if I joined the Coast Guard, I could help the community in that way. A few years ago, on a New Year's Day, a fisherman got washed off on the pier at Amble here. Both lifeboats were launched along with ourselves. When we actually got to the incident, unfortunately, the fisherman had drowned, whilst the lifeboat tried to rescue the casualty. The lifeboat actually capsized at the same time. Then we had three live casualties in the water, as well as the deceased. On that afternoon, we got Rescue 131, the helicopter, to come and assist. Whilst we got out the live casualties, the helicopter rescued the deceased.
The sea, somewhere waiting for me. My lover stands on golden sands and watches the ships that go sailing somewhere beyond the sea. She's there watching for me. If I could fly like birds on high, then straight to her arms, I'll go sailing. It's far beyond the stars.